murder, Ernesto. She isn't going with you. Please leave. She wasn't kidnapped. She went with Camilo willingly. What you have done to her in the past is enough. She doesn't need this. Leave them in peace.
What's wrong, Orlando?
Please help me.
What's the matter with you? Hey, what's wrong?
Huh? I have never loved and will never love anyone as much as I love you. Orlando, what I did then was a mistake. And it won't happen again.
I am prepared to risk everything that I have for you, Orlando. But you're still in love with Camilo. Just like before, you still choose him now. And just like before, he will never defeat me. Once again, I'll see him fall. I promise you, I'll do whatever it takes, Orlando.
There's another thing that I'd like to tell you. Your father told me about your ex-boyfriend, about Lawrence. I'm sorry, but I really think you should know about this. I've been enemies with Lawrence's father. It's been going on for ages, since we were children. Especially with Orlando, or Ola. Ernesto and I have always been rivals.
With Ola, uncle? Ola, the one who saved Lawrence?
Yes, the same person. Ernesto and Frida are the reasons why she became crazy. And they are capable of doing many things just to get what they want. But don't worry. I'm helping Ola get better.
Wait, uncle. I'm getting confused.
I know. It's hard for me to explain. I am just thinking about you and Lawrence.
And how did Lawrence and I get involved in this situation?
I don't want you to get hurt and get involved with our family's feud. Ernesto is my enemy. And if you still love Lawrence...
Uncle, you don't have anything to worry about. Lawrence and I are already over, and I have a new boyfriend who loves me. There are a lot of painful memories between us.
It was Frida. I'm sure that woman did many awful things to the two of you, right? What an evil woman. She just won't stop.
Uncle, it's all right. It's over and done with. I just want to forget about it. You know what, uncle? I don't even know if Lawrence and I can still be friends. So many bad things happened.
Don't worry. Our trials will end soon. We'll find peace again.
Essing, thank you for what you did. For stopping Ernesto. If it's possible, I don't want to ever see him again. Because I just remember the horrible things he did to me. Both he and Frida.
Orlando. Orlando, it's okay now. Don't think about it.
missing. There's something that I'd like to ask of you.
What is it? Anything. Tell me.
So, Jian, are you going to tell me about it or not?
I'm really not sure.
Okay, fine. You don't have to. You know, we haven't seen each other for a long time, and you choose to be embarrassed now?
All right.
No, you don't have to.
Lawrence.
What?
Karis, Mary Girl.
There you go. I knew it, Jian. Finally.
I feel happy, I really do.
You know, I've known all along that you had a crush on her. It's just you're so slow, man. You don't act quickly.
It's your fault, you know, because you weren't there. I didn't have anyone to run to ask advice from. And honestly, I didn't know what to do. But now, I sort of understand, you know, when you love someone so much. And now, I understand why you were such a nervous wreck when you were courting Shello. Oh, sorry, man. You know what? I hope you don't get mad. You see, you can't lie to me. Just one look at you. I know you're still feeling something for Shello. I know you're thinking about Romer. But he'll understand, you know. Didn't you say a long time ago? If you love somebody, you'll fight for her. So, why don't you do that now? Why don't you fight for Shello? Lawrence, don't say it's too late for you. Because until Shello gets married to anyone, there's still a chance for you to get together.
Jian, she already loves someone else.
But you're hurting inside, and you'd rather choose to keep quiet.
You know, I can't force myself on her anymore, Jian. Besides, she's already happy. She and Romer are happy. Why should I get between them?
Whatever.
You know, I'm really not sure anymore if I should be happy that you're here. You're just like Allison, you know? You both sound like my conscience. But you know what, Jian? Seriously. If I can just bring back what Shello and I had, I'd do it. If I could just erase everything that had happened, I'd do it. But I can't. That's why, Jian. Learn from my mistakes.
Yeah. Good evening, Miss Ebony.
Oh, hi.
Is Shello ready?
She's still making herself pretty. Come sit down.
Thank you.
Shello, honey.
Wow. My girl's so pretty. Is her uncle here? He might have to smack me.
He's no longer here. He went back to Monte Gracia. And you don't have to worry because he's actually rooting for you.
Well, that's good. You know I'm so lucky. From now on, I promise you everything will be okay.
Go easy on the salt on this one, okay?
Yes, ma'am.
It's not good for Romer. Where in the world is that boy? He said they'd be early. There, that's right. Finish all of that.
Yes.
Hello? Hello, Allison. Is Romer there?
Oh, hi, Aunt Margaret. No, he's not here. He left the house early this morning and... Wait, I'll
ask Margaret.
Laura.
Let me talk to
Hold
her.
Hold on, Aunt Frieda wants to speak with you.
Margaret? How are you?
Frieda! Oh, what a pleasant surprise. When did you arrive?
You know, I'm the one who's supposed to ask that. How was the cruise that you took? Was it enjoyable? You know, I think we should get together. We haven't seen each other for a long, long time. Are you free for dinner tonight?
Oh, I'm sorry, but I'm having dinner in the house with Romer and his girlfriend.
Oh, Shallow. Yes, I heard that. Did you know that she's the ex-girlfriend of Lawrence?
So, does it matter?
Well, I'm not implying anything, Margaret, okay? Anyway, let's not talk about that. So, when would you like to meet? Let's set a date for dinner. When are you free? Okay. Bye.
Bye.
Guys, we're not having dinner at home tonight. There's a big party at Aunt Margaret's house and we've been invited. So, come on, let's go.
Come on.
Lawrence, get ready.
Excuse me for a while, ma'am.
Sure.
Orlando. Is he here?
Essing. Essing, thank you.
I leave you two alone now.
Essing, please, please. Please don't let Camilla know of this for now.
Don't worry, I'll take care of it.
Thank you.
Give me that. Thank you.
Joaquin, it's a good thing you escaped. I thought Camilo's men had killed you.
Come on, let's go. This is our chance to escape. I'll get you out of here.
We should hurry. Mother might get angry with us. We're already late.
Hey, finally.
Mother.
Hello,
how are you?
We're okay. I'm sorry if we're late, because someone here took a long time choosing flowers.
Hey, stop that. This is for my mother. It's supposed to be special.
Flatterer. Thanks, darling. Come, have a seat.
Okay.
Who could that be? I'm not expecting anyone.
Hi, Margaret! How are you? Oh, my goodness. Long time no see. Nice to see you. Oh, my goodness, Romer. Look at you. You're so tall. It's been so long, dear, since I saw you.
Romer, why didn't you tell me?
I didn't know.
Frieda, what are you doing here?
Oh my goodness, I know, Margaret. But you know what? After we talked on the phone earlier, I realized how much I missed you. We haven't seen each other in a long time, and goodness, look at Romer. I haven't seen him in so long. I figured you're having a dinner party. Why not come and join you, right? In fact, we haven't spoken in how long, huh? I'd really like for us to catch up and talk, Margaret.
But I have a guest.
You mean Shallow? Margaret, don't worry about her. I'm sure this girl won't mind at all if we join you for dinner. Isn't that right, Shallow?
It's okay. I don't mind.
See? I told you, Margaret. Shallow. You know Lawrence, Kara and Gian, right? Romer, Margaret, this is Kara and Gian. They are my adopted children from Monte Gracia. Wait, Shallow, I don't think you've met Allison before, right?
Oh, Shallow, that's Allison, Lawrence's girlfriend.
Mother, I'll explain about that later.
Oh my goodness, Lawrence, don't worry about it. Son, my goodness, imagine. I'm so happy for you. Margaret, aren't you going to invite us to sit down?
I'm so sorry. Please have a seat.
Thank you.
Wait, Joaquin. I can't leave this place.
Orlando, this is our chance.
I can't leave this place, Joaquin. I'm safe here.
Orlana, please don't tell me. Camilo left you once. Don't tell me you believe him again.
Joaquin is taking care of me here. And I really need Camilo's help. Joaquin, my memories are coming back. Once in a while, I hear my child crying for me, calling to me, and everywhere I look, I can see her begging me, asking me. My hands are covered in blood. Her diaphragm. My baby. Joaquin, I'm going insane again. I think I'm going crazy. And so, Joaquin, I won't be able to be at peace until I've taken my revenge on Frida. I will not leave here. Camilo will help me.
Eloise, Derek, good job. Shella seems to be all right. I don't think I'll have any problems with her.
Are you sure about that?
I'm sure, Derek. We've already talked. And I see that she's happy with that Romer fellow. And I think Romer is a good person. Even though he's related to Lawrence. He's going to fight for her if something happens.
But sir, from what I have seen, it looked like Shiela's is still in love with Lawrence.
That is why your work's not done yet. Be alert. Eloise, those two are not supposed to get back together no matter what happens. And she will only listen to you, to your advice. Derek, what's the news with your sister?
She's okay. But the baby's still in the intensive care unit.
All right. Keep me posted. During the elections, I'll expect you in Montegracia. Mm-hmm. Understood?
Mm-hmm. So, Shello, how have you been? I heard that you had to stop school. Are you okay? Oh, I'm sorry.
I'm okay. Everything's fine. I'll be enrolling next semester, and I think my uncle will help me.
Oh, that's right. The rich uncle. Camilo, right? That's his name?
Mm-hmm.
Well, at least you got to know him now. No wonder, son, right? You look much better now. I mean, you've cleaned up. Nicer clothes, your hair is better. You know, really, Shello, it's amazing what money can do, right?
I worked hard for this, and it's not me who's rich. It's my uncle.
Oh, yes, that's right. Your rich uncle. You might have been wondering, Margaret. I've known Shello for a long time, when she was poor. And, we usually don't get along very well when it came to certain decisions. Oh, did you know that about your girlfriend? Isn't that right, Lawrence?
Shello, come with me for a while. I want to show you something. Excuse us.
What I'm worried about are you and Kara, especially Kara. From what I heard from Camila's plans, it's no longer safe for her to stay at the mansion.
But Orlando, I've been wanting to take Kara from there, but that girl's become so stubborn. It looks like she's falling for Gia.
That's not allowed to happen. Joaquin, if there is one thing that I truly regret, this is it. I shouldn't have involved you and Kara into this. This is not your fight. Joaquin, listen to what I have to say. Take Kara away from this. Leave this place. Tell her that it came from me. She'll listen.
She's in Manila right now. I will hide her there. But what about you, Orlando? I just can't leave you here.
Joaquin, don't worry about me. I can take care of myself. I have faith in Camilo. Take care away. I'll be all right.
Shallow, I'm so sorry. I didn't expect Frida to barge in like this. I just told her that the three of us were having dinner together and... I'm really sorry.
Aunt, it's all right.
I don't know the story between you and Frida, but... knowing my cousin, I'm sure she was one of the reasons why you broke up with Lawrence.
Yes, you're right. But it's been over for a long time now. You shouldn't worry. I'm already used to Dr. Frida. If I could stand her back then I can face her more now.
That's what I like about you, Shello. You're really brave. Romer's really lucky to have someone like you. As for Frida, don't worry about her, okay? This is my house. One word from her, and out she goes. Okay? Don't worry.
Thank you, ma'am.
Let's go back.
Okay.
Shello?
Is it all right if I stayed here a while?
Sure.
With Jian? Jian, how have you been?
I've missed you. Shello? I'm really sorry. I hope you understand. They're my family.
Jian, it's okay. In all honesty, I forgot all about that. For me, it was all just a really big bad dream. Look at me now. Didn't I tell you I'll be successful? You can see that I'm quite all right. Don't worry, I understand your situation. Actually, I just miss you horribly. I really miss our companionship.
Jian, Aunt Frida's calling for you. Shello.
Kara.
Shello. We're a couple.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Shello, you know? I already know how it feels. I already know how to love. And now I understand both you and Lawrence. I understand more than you. You know what, Shello? I think you just don't want to look because you're still hurting. Shello, please don't get mad. I know that Romer and you are a couple. But I know that you still can't forget Lawrence. Shello, you and Lawrence had a very deep and meaningful relationship. That's why it can't be forgotten. Even if you love someone else, Shello.
Let's go. They might be looking for us. Come on.
Lawrence, I hope they catch the person who did that to you. How awful. The things kids get into these days.
Well, the whole gang's gone into hiding. You know, I heard that all the members have already gone to America.
Oh, son, don't worry. I will make sure that each and every one of those boys will get caught and will pay for what they did to you. Goodness. You know, I wish I could say that it's not really partly his fault, but Ernesto and I have been getting him a number of bodyguards. But he just keeps on firing them. Look at you now. You got yourself a bodyguard. You courted her and made her your girlfriend. You know, I didn't actually expect Lawrence to stay single long, so don't be embarrassed, Allison. I mean, Lawrence has taste. And how can he resist someone as pretty as you? Huh? You're smart, beautiful, and I'm sure very loving as well. What more could a mother want for her son, right? Somebody who would love him and take care of him unselfishly.
I think dinner is ready. So, Frida, how is Ernesto? Why didn't you bring him along?
Well, you know, Margaret, he's so busy. You should know. Politics. I mean, it's not yet elections and he already has competition. As a matter of fact, one of them is, Shallow's uncle, Camilo. So tell me, Shallow, now that your uncle has returned, I'm sure that your horrid family problems have lessened. Oh my goodness, Margaret, let me tell you. You see, when Shallow was still Lawrence's girlfriend, he did nothing but worry about her family. There was one time her father was sent to jail. Goodness. Lawrence didn't know what he was supposed to do to help this helpless girl. He's always confused. You know what? I hope that doesn't happen to you again, Shallow. It's just sad. And if it ever did, imagine. Your life's going to be hell, Romer. I'm just warning you, Margaret. I'm telling you.
Mother.
You know, Aunt, it doesn't really matter. Whatever problem Shella's family have, I love her. I've accepted her for who she is, where she came from. I know that she's an orphan, and that they're quite poor. She couldn't go to school because her father was imprisoned, and their theater has been sold. You know, in fact, there's really nothing you can say that will make me change the way I feel about her. I really love her.
Well then, I'm really happy for the two of you. But wait a minute, please. You see, I just want to know, Shallow, was it true that you didn't know that Romer and Lawrence are cousins? And
Mother,
and,
stop.
I'm sorry, Romer, you really didn't know that Shallow's the ex-girlfriend of my son?
What is it that you want to say to me, Dr. Frieda?
Nothing really.
You know, I just find it a little bit of a coincidence that of all the men in the world, you got cousins as boyfriends, Shallow.
Mother, please.
I mean, isn't that kind of weird?
Frieda, please.
What, Margaret? It's just an observation. I mean, really, I'm so curious. Imagine, two men and they're cousins. One's your ex and the other's your boyfriend. I mean, how does that feel, Shallow? Don't you feel weird? Aren't you ill at ease?
Mother, please, cut it out.
Do you want to know if I feel ill at ease, Doctor? Or if I'm having a hard time? Well, I don't, because if I felt that, then I'd have broken up with Romer. Maybe it's you's having a hard time. You just can't accept that I'm here and I'm still a part of your life. You can't accept that I'm here and that I've made my life better even after you've tried to make it miserable. Excuse me, I need to go to the restroom.
Oh, you can use the one in my bedroom, darling. Just go upstairs. It's the second door to the right.
Okay, thank you. I'm really embarrassed with Dr. Frieda. She's still very angry with you, even though you've broken up with Lawrence. Don't worry, it's just me she has issues with. Because I can see that she likes you for her son. But just be careful. Good luck. Hopefully you don't undergo what I went through in the past. Shella, wait! I'm not your enemy. The reason I came here is because I need to tell you something about Lawrence. Lawrence and I are... You don't need to explain, Allison. Just leave me alone. Shallow, wait! Shallow, please?
What? What? Did I say something wrong? I was just asking.
As usual.
Shallow's so sensitive about all the things I ask of her. She hasn't changed. As always,
Aunt Frida, you were very rude to her. I'll go find Shiloh. Excuse me.
Excuse me.
Shiloh? Shiloh, look, I'm sorry, okay? Please talk to me. I didn't know she'd do that.
Romer, I'm very sorry.
Man, what is wrong with your mother?
I don't know. I'm really sorry. Please accept my apology on behalf of my mother.
Shiloh? Shiloh? She's not here. She might have left. I look for her.
Cousin. I'm really sorry.
It's not your fault.
Shiloh, wait, please listen to me. Allison, I really don't want to hear about what you have to say about you and Lawrence. I don't care. A lot of things have happened to me tonight. I don't want you to add more to it.
Shiloh, wait, please.
What the hell's your mother's problem with me, huh? Why won't your family leave me alone? I know that we've broken up, Lawrence. So she shouldn't butt in my life. So all of you shouldn't give a damn about my life.
Shiloh, I'm sorry.
Hey, Allison, have you seen Shiloh? I can't find her anywhere, and the guard said she hasn't left yet.
Isn't it enough for her that we broke up, Lawrence? Why does she want to go between Romer and I?
Are you okay?
Yes. It's just that I started feeling dizzy. Is it all right if I just went home, Romer?
Do you want medicine?
No, I'll just sleep on it.
Okay, but let's say goodbye to Mother first. Lawrence?
Hmm?
Just follow inside.
Okay.
Frida, why'd you do that? I can't understand you. Shiloh is such a nice girl.
Look, Margaret. If you can accept that Shiloh is the girlfriend of your son, well, for me, even to share a simple meal with her is not an acceptable thing.
Then you shouldn't have come. You knew she was my visitor. A person whom I respect. She's my son's girlfriend. Hopefully this doesn't happen again, Frida. So that it won't be us having problems later.
Look, Margaret. I don't know what that girl did to you and your son to make you like her. All I care about is that she no longer stands in the way of my son's future.
They're here, Aunt Margaret, I'll be saying goodbye now. We'll be leaving now.
It's still too early, Shallow. Why don't you stay? Anyway, Romer's taking you home, right?
Mother's just not feeling well.
Yes, ma'am.
If you really have to go, come with me to the kitchen. I'll give you something, okay? Oh, come.
Sure.
Excuse us, Romer. Yes, come in.
Orlando, here.
Thank you, Essing.
Well, Orlando, can I speak with you?
What is it, Essing?
Don't be offended with what I'll ask you, but who was that man? Is he a relative?
He's just a friend. Essing, thank you. But if it's all right with you, I'd appreciate it if we didn't tell Camilo about Joaquin's visit today. I'll be the one to tell him about it.
If that's what you want. But, Orlando, about earlier, when Ernesto came here, I think we should keep that from Camilo. I'm afraid of what he'll do to Ernesto when he finds out about it.
Whatever Camilo does to Ernesto, it won't be enough compared to the horrible things he did to me, Essing. He should pay for all of his sins, Essing. Here you go. I made this for you. Bring it home to your family.
Aunt Margaret, I think that this is just too much.
What do you mean, too much? I won't treat you any differently, Shallow. You're like a daughter to me now. I'm really glad you make Romer happy. Every time I see the two of you together, I somehow forget what he's going through. You're the one who makes him healthy, Shallow.
I really do hope that Romer gets well. That's what I always pray for.
Me too, Shala. Me too. But I know that there's no certainty to everything. Even if he continues his chemo, he can still have a relapse. I don't want to think about what else could happen to him.
Good night, ma'am. I'll leave now.
Thank you. Thank you as well, Shallow.
Good night.
Till next time, okay?
Okay.
I'll be back. I'll just bring her home.
Take care.
Oh, Shallow. I left the keys. Just give me a minute.
Shallow, dear. It was really nice to see you again. Mwah. You really have some nerve, you know. But if this is your tactic to get close to my son again, you're mistaken.
Be thankful, Dr. Frieda, that we are here at Aunt Margaret's house, so I won't make a fool of you. And if you're wondering about Lawrence, your son, oh, don't worry. I've forgotten about him. He's all yours, Doctor.
Well, if that's the case, very good then.
Mother?
Good night.
Mother, let's go.
You okay?
Okay.
Lawrence, I think I'll stay here tonight.
Sure, take care. Shallow?
Bye, Shallow.
Well, Margaret, thanks for dinner. I think we can go home now.
Gian, Kara, good luck on your dance contest. I hope you win.
Thank you, Miss Margaret.
Thank you, Miss Margaret.
Let's go, guys. Good night.
We'll go now. Good night.
Okay. All right. It's all right, Lawrence. It's all right. Go on. Your mother's waiting for you.
Shelo, I'm really sorry about what happened earlier. And I'm sorry about Aunt Frida.
It's okay, Romer. It wasn't your fault. Besides, I'm already used to Dr. Frida. What you did earlier? That's nothing. I endured more horrible things from her in the past. For me and my family.
But why? I really don't understand why she's still harboring ill feelings towards you, and you're no longer with Lawrence. You know what? If she isn't Lawrence's mother, I think you two will still be together. I'm sorry. I didn't mean that. But I just can't understand what you went through under Aunt Frida. But I hope you don't think my mother's the same as she.
I know that rumor. They may be related, but Aunt Margaret's very different from the doctor.
Well, my mother loves you. And I love you too. I just wish you knew me first. Instead of my cousin.
I wish that too, because you're really different from him.
All right, go to sleep. I'll just pick you up tomorrow, okay?
Okay, be careful.
Good night.
Good night.
You're sure you don't want to sleep here tonight?
Yes, Mother. We'll just go home. Mother? You see, I didn't like the way you treated Shallow earlier. It was embarrassing to Romer and Aunt Margaret.
Why, Lawrence? Did I say something that wasn't true? Huh?
But Mother...
What? If there's someone here who should be angry, it's me. How many secrets have you been keeping from me, huh? You had an accident. Did you tell me? And the one with Romer and Shallow, you didn't say anything. And about your new girlfriend, her, that bodyguard. My goodness, when were you going to let me know about the two of you, huh?
Mother.
What? You know, it's frightening. Because you live in one apartment.
Mother, what are you thinking? We're not doing anything wrong.
You better make sure, Lawrence. And you. I don't exactly like you for my son. But if it's any consolation, I'd pick you instead of that provincial girl.
Mother, please stop that.
Fine. If you don't want to sleep here, then you better get going.
Good night.
Take care.